A few weeks ago, Hans gave me a shout asking if I wanted to go riding in Livigno, and I of course jumped at the chance. And Hans has been riding in Livigno for a while now, so it was really cool to get shown all the different trails and a few secret trails as well.
It's been a good week of riding. It's cool to have Danny here. You know, he's so enthusiastic about any kind of riding, and we both brought a few different bikes. Down by the river, I was drawn by your grace into depths of oblivion and to the lover's place. Livigno is definitely an adventurous place, and there's so much wilderness surrounded by pure nature. We call it the heart of the Alps.
This place has got so much to offer. I mean, you've got lifts to the top of these, you know, huge mountains, but you can also do some amazing cross-country loops. Also good training up here. You know, the altitude, you know, for the first couple of days was something that was, you'd say, breathtaking. You know, made some of the climbs, you know, quite hard work, but it was really worth it. Really cool for me to get to ride with Hans, because I grew up watching his videos and was always inspired by them.
Had a really good week. We got to see a lot of different sites of Livigno. It's been the hardest days for you. Let's throw
them out the window, that's what those lovers do. There's a really good balance out in the trails, where, you know, you're riding down, there is other people about. I mean, but then there's also, you can go and find your own part of the trail as well. You know, you can feel like you're the only one out there. So it's really good to see the kind of scene growing there. And I think it's only going to get better. You know, it seems like the kind of place that you could, you know, ride a new trail every day, you know, for a year, and then I think you find everything, and you suddenly find a secret trail somewhere, and you know, it's just a sort of mountain biking paradise. We left Livigno and drove a few kilometres, you know, up the valley. Basically, we came up over the mountain pass and over the kind of saddle. You just see the whole mountainside presented in the sun right in front of us. It's just incredible, and it was something straight out of Utah.
Dropping
on the top.
On the top.
You see us standing there. There's another little ridge behind there.
The most epic descent I've ever seen. Kind of like, I don't really know how to describe it. It's kind of proper free ride kind of stuff.
Something I have been eyeing for 5-6 years, and I thought that was the proper occasion to finally do it when Danny arrived. So we had out there with Julian, one of the local riders, and did it.
We had Julian, the local downhill skier slash maniac, come and join us. He'd actually done a first descent on this sort of crazy mountainside before, so it was nice kind of having a guide of some sort, you know, to kind of go down through the pinnacles. But he didn't really explain what we were kind of getting ourselves into, and it's fine the first, you know, 100 meters, but then it kind of went into this funnel where you had, you know, you couldn't do any turns, so it was just straight down the mountainside. It felt pretty wild. Certainly one of the more wild descents I've ever done. Felt very lucky to kind of to make it down through some of those chutes. But once it opened out, you could kind of get some nice lines in, and you know, it's the kind of terrain I've grown up watching and, you know, free ride DVDs. It was really cool to be kind of riding some of that stuff for myself. Hans knows the place so well. I mean, we got shown the best trails. Yeah, we were in Livigno for 5 days, and we didn't ride the same trail twice. you know, this trip's really offered, you know, the whole kind of range, just awesome. So much fun. Some of the funnest things I've ever ridden my bike.